Hello everyone, I am Amandeep here. In this video, we are going to continue the word processing session. So let's start with the next topic of the word processing, that is document template. So what is template? Template is a collection of styles which defines paragraph styles, a title and a different levels of headings. Or in other words, you can say that templates are a type of document that were already designed. They help you save time and keep your document consistent. Now we will learn how to insert, how to save or reuse, how to insert text in a template. Now to insert template, click on the file tab, then click on the new, then choose sample templates. Now you can see here collection of different styles of templates such as letters, newsletters, reports, resume, etc. Now suppose I need to create a newsletter, then choose a newsletter. So as a document, create, click on the create button. You can see now it is designed with the paragraph headings, titles, styles, text box, fonts, etc. So all you have to do is replace the sample text with your own text. Now how to insert a text? Just click on the, type the company name. Here I want to change the text here, then click on the text. Now you can see it is selected or it is highlight the text. Then I can enter the text here by pressing the keys from the keyboard. Suppose I am making this newsletter for a school. Then I type the name of the school. Then what is the title of the newsletter? Just click on the title. You can see it is select, it is highlighted, and now I can enter the title, suppose toppers of the year. I'm going to make toppers of the year newsletter for the school. Then I give the title here. Then what is the story title and what is the sidebar title? You can add this. You can also add the pictures. So this is the way how to create a template and how to insert the text into the template. Now you can also design your own template and also save it for future use and can reuse that template whenever you need. How you create your own template? Now first click on the file, then click on the new, then click on the my templates option here. Now create new blank template, just choose blank template, create new as a template and click OK. Now I can design my own template. Suppose I need to create a certifying to make a format of certificate in templates. So just I give the borders . So I'm going to give the page border. Then make it landscape. certificate of appreciation. Certificate is presented to name, surname, like this. Now I can save this template by clicking file, save as. You can see here word template showing save as type word template. You can save it as a certificate. I give the name certificate template and then click save. Now it is saved. Now when I need to create a certificate template, just go to the open and then certificate template, click on the open. Now I can edit here name. Okay. This is the way how to create your own template. Now I can use it many times. So the next topic is working with page and section breaks. So what is page break and what is section break? Page break is used to separate the contents between pages. After the page break, the following text will allow start at the beginning of the next page. And the section break is used to divide the document into the sections. Once section breaks are inserted, you can format each section separately. Now, I'm showing you how to insert a page break, how to insert column, text wrapping, section breaks, and how to delete a section break. So now how to insert page break? Page break option is available under the insert tab also. Here is page break option and it is also available in the page layout under the page setup group breaks drop down list. You can see here page breaks and section break. In the page break, first is page break. First I need a text in the document. Now suppose I am typing a book in a document. After complete one chapter, I want to start the next chapter from next page. For this, I have to press enter key again and again to go to or to jump to the next page. Instead of pressing enter key, I am just use page break. Just click at the end of the text and then go to the page setup group, click on the breaks drop down list page. Now you can see your cursor jump to the next page. You can also use the shortcut key of page break, that is control plus enter key. The next is column break. Column break is used to separate the text into the columns. First of all, insert two columns. Now you can see when I click on the second column, I can't able to click and I also can't able to type the text here. Or column break is used to move the cursor into the next column. Just click at the end of the text. Click on the break option and then click column break. You can see now cursor moves to the next column. So this is the way of using column break. The next is text wrapping. So text wrapping is used to move the text to the next line. Just if I want to move this text, when you create a picture, this line moves to the next new line, then click on the break and click on the text wrapping. You can see this line moves to the next line. So the next is section break. Section break contains four options: next page, continuous, even page, or odd page. The next page, insert the section break and start the new section on the next page. So look here, when I change the page into landscape, you can see all the pages are landscaped. And if I change margin, all pages have same margin. But if I use section break, click on the next page, section break. Click next page. Now if I select first page and I change the orientation to landscape, you can see now only first page change the orientation and the second page is portrait. If I change the third page into landscape, you can see I can handle different pages by separately. Now the next is continuous break. Continuous break, insert a section break and start the new section on the same page. It works on a same page. So look here, I have two pages and in the first page I do nothing, I have not applied anything. But in the second page, when I click on the first paragraph at the starting point and go to the breaks and then choose continuous section break, and similarly in the second paragraph add continuous break, and in the third paragraph add continuous break. And in the first page, if I click on the first line of the paragraph and add a colons, you can see all the three paragraphs converted into two columns. But in second page I use continuous break. If I click on the first paragraph, I have no need to select the paragraph. Just click, when I click on the starting point of the paragraph and use two columns, you can see only first paragraph converted into columns. And if last paragraph click two, then it will convert it into two columns. Okay, so this, the continuous section break works only a same page. And next is even page and odd page. Even page, insert a section break and start a new section on the next even numbered pages like 2, 4, 6, 8. And odd page, insert a section break and start the new section on the next odd numbered pages like 1, 3, 5, 7. So we can use even and odd section break also. And how to delete a section break? To delete a section break, just go to the View tab and click on the Draft. You can see here all the breaks appear on the screen, and which I want to remove, click on the break and press the delete key from the keyboard. The break will remove. Click on the break and press the delete key from the keyboard. Like this, I can remove all the breaks from the page.